A very common process that we have in refineries is the Merox process, or mercaptan oxidization. So after we've done our initial cleaning, if you like, with the amine systems, we then need to further reduce the amount of sulfur in the oils, in the feeds. And we do that through removing the mercaptans, which are another store, if you like, of the sulfur in these units. So when we think about a Merox unit and we think about the risks, so one risk is obviously the safe to operate risk of the asset and ensuring that there isn't any breach of integrity. But the other risk we talk about is a financial risk. And like an amine system, a Merox unit is a key system in clearing up or cleaning your feed to then send that to market and to create revenue for the plant. So a number of different organizations have done investigations looking at the cost of maintenance and the cost of shutdowns of these types of units. So this is one example which we identified where in Saudi Arabia, a company had done a detailed look at what the cost was to the plant when the Merox unit was down. So what do we need to do? Well, effectively, we need to prevent the conditions in the units, the environment, from reacting and changing the substrate, which can then lead to the corrosion, the loss of our wall thickness, and then, you know, the challenges that we see with integrity. So let's look at a couple of case histories. So the first is an example which sort of talks to what we were discussing earlier with the costs of operating a Merox unit. So for this particular client, this unit was extremely expensive in the sense that the original vessel, which was bought in 2011, failed. They had a major failure and they had to replace the vessel in 2015. So they replaced the vessel in 2015 and they decided to use an organic internal lining in order to prevent the failure reoccurring. But what they then found upon inspection was that the internal organic lining was not protecting the substrate. And they had a breakdown of the lining, which was then leading again to the initiation of pitting corrosion and the initiation of some cracking. So they contacted IGS. They were aware of the activity that we were already carrying out on different units. And they decided to go with an application using a thermal spray applied alloy.
A follow-up question about galvanic corrosion. It's a hot topic. Because amine and caustic equipments will have moisture, how is it safe from galvanic corrosion again?
I think the reason why it's safe is because for galvanic corrosion to take place, you need to maintain that that moisture in the zone where there's the galvanic risk. And we just haven't seen that in 20 years of application in the field. So the theory, you know, is that you have to have all of these elements in order for the galvanic corrosion, and you've got to have that pathway through the liquid in order for the reaction to happen. And we just don't see that in the field. If there's certain areas of the vessel, like if there's certain trays where you do get a buildup of liquid, then obviously we'll address that by making sure the application goes outside that liquid level, as I said. So we look at each application to ensure that we eliminate or mitigate that galvanic risk. So I understand your argument. We have actually done some testing. We've written a pretty good technical memo on that specific subject. So if you would like some more information, just let us know and we'll send you a copy of a technical memo. And hopefully that would answer the question. And if you have more questions, you know, you're welcome to ask.